Radicalized shooter picked Mandalay Bay for specific reason besides concert location. Here's what's inside. Sunday night, 64-year-old Stephen Paddock opened fire from his 32nd floor suite of the Mandalay Bay Resort. He mowed down thousands of innocent concertgoers who were just there to have fun and enjoy an outdoor music festival on the Las Vegas Strip. 59 people, including Paddock, are believed to have died and over 500 were injured in the massacre. 14 of the injured are still believed to be in critical condition at local area hospitals. But as of today, little to nothing is being said about the murderer and his motives. Paddock, who police believe shot himself before they were able to gain access to the room from which he committed his heinous crime, is a white man who, according to his brother, had no strong political or religious affiliations whatsoever. LV and PD have labeled the act a lone wolf attack and have stated that it is not a terror-related incident. However, ISIS did claim responsibility for the attack via its news agency. They stated that Paddock converted to Islam several months ago. However, the militant group provided no evidence to support its claim and is basically in shambles since President Trump took office and got tough on their infrastructure. The only solid link to Islam that has been proven up to now is that Hillary supporter, Jim Murren, CEO of MGM, which owns Mandalay Bay Casino and Resort, petitioned employees to donate to the terrorist organization known as CARE only 2 months before the shooting. Murren's wife worked for Obama. The only other viable theory that is left is that the man just snapped. BJ Piz reports. Abstract background. The relationship between cognition and age at onset of schizophrenia is largely unknown. Aims. To compare cognitive deficits in individuals with youth-onset and late-onset schizophrenia with those in adults with first-episode schizophrenia. Method. 29 databases, including Embase, Midline and PsycINFO, were searched from 1980 to 2008. Selected publications had to include healthy controls and analyze separately individuals diagnosed with schizophrenia or related disorder and individuals with first episode, youth onset or late onset schizophrenia. Descriptive and cognitive data were extracted and the latter aggregated into 22 cognitive measures. Cohen's effect size raw and weighted means of cognitive deficits were generated and compared in the three groups. Results. Individuals with youth onset and first episode schizophrenia demonstrate large deficits, mean effect size greater than or equal to 0.8, on almost all cognitive measures. Individuals with youth onset schizophrenia demonstrate larger deficits than those with first episode schizophrenia on arithmetic, executive function, IQ, psychomotor speed of processing and verbal memory. In contrast, those with late-onset schizophrenia demonstrate minimal deficits on arithmetic, digit symbol coding and vocabulary, but larger ones on attention, fluency, global cognition, IQ and visuospatial construction. Conclusions. Individuals with youth-onset schizophrenia have severe cognitive deficits, whereas those with late-onset schizophrenia have some relatively preserved cognitive functions. This finding supports the view that severity of the disease process is associated with different ages and onset. In addition, the cognitive pattern of people with late-onset schizophrenia suggests that their deficits are specific rather than solely as a result of aging and related factors. Schizophrenia is a diverse disorder. One facet of its diversity is the age at onset. The incidence of schizophrenia peaks between 10 and 25 years for men and between 25 and 35 for women. One another peak, particularly among women, occurs in midlife. About 23% of people with schizophrenia experience their first episode after the age of 40.2 in a small group of people. Schizophrenia has its onset after age 60, which has been defined as very late onset schizophrenia-like psychosis. 3. Finally, onset of schizophrenia can occur in childhood or adolescence, typically after the age of 5. Its prevalence is about 1 per 10,000 in children, and 1 to 2 per 1,000 in adolescents. As in early adulthood, higher rates are reported in young males than in young females. 4. Delisi has conceptualized age at onset as a surrogate measure of severity of the disease process. 5. An earlier age at onset has been associated with more severe clinical and behavioral symptoms. 6, 7 more social disability. 8 narrower posterior brain segments. 9 and larger ventricles. 10 cognitive deficits in schizophrenia are core features of the illness. 11, 12 they are the strongest predictors of function and are considered potential targets for treatment. 13 they have been well characterized, for example by Heaton et al., 14 Hoff et al., 15 and White et al., 16 and are believed to be the manifestation of the disease process affecting different brain systems. Thus, characterizing the relationship between age at onset and cognitive deficits will illuminate from a cognitive perspective the unraveling of the disease process at different levels of severity. Although some studies have reported an association of earlier age at onset and more severe cognitive deficits, 6,17 to 19 others failed to find differences in the cognitive profiles of individuals with early V. Late-onset schizophrenia. 14,20,21 Further, the nature of the cognitive deficits that may be associated with age at onset has varied in different studies. Considering that several of these studies have small sample sizes, and to assess whether such associations exist across the lifespan, we present a meta-analysis of the literature, estimating and comparing the severity of cognitive deficits in patients with adult onset at their first episode of schizophrenia, youth onset, in childhood or adolescence, schizophrenia and late-onset schizophrenia. We chose to compare individuals with youth-onset or late-onset schizophrenia only to people with adult-onset schizophrenia at their first episode because individuals with youth-onset and late-onset schizophrenia are typically studied close to the onset of the illness. By contrast, in individuals with adult-onset schizophrenia who have been ill for many years, one would expect chronicity and treatment to influence cognitive deficits, thus, confounding the hypothesized specific relationships to age at onset. In this report, we use the word schizophrenia to refer to schizophrenia and related disorders, schizoaffective, schizophreniform, delusional disorder, or very late onset schizophrenia like psychosis. As we learn from the above article, this would be a very unlikely scenario. In the mental health field, it's a known fact that it's extremely rare that a person who has never had any history of any type of mental issues would suddenly be afflicted by a mental disease after the age of 45. Paddock was 64 and the only run-in he had ever had with law enforcement was a traffic ticket 7 years ago. An upstanding citizen like this doesn't just snap. And even if he had, this act took extreme planning and coordination. Planning could have taken months or even years to carry out with this perfection. Plus, would a man who owns multiple properties and even a plane be willing to lose all that just overnight? The official story we have been getting up to now just doesn't seem to pass the smell test. Please share if you want to get to the bottom of this.